This here looks like an app, a normal app. You can do stuff if I can do this. Oh. See, you can change things. It runs rather smooth. You can do this. Rating. And you can scroll. This is coded in 48 lines of JavaScript in React Native. I haven't really got a development tool. I've done the development on a site called expo.io, and I want to show you the source code. This is the source code. So I simply open a browser, and then I can code my JavaScript. To show you just how it works, I want to show you how instant this works. I want to try to, if you can see my iPhone here, and if I enter an alert somewhere, let's say around here. And I write an alert. You can see my iPhone is connected to this code using an online site. So if I type alert here, you see as I type the iPhone is updated. So if I type alert, and then let's just enter any number here, let's say 4. You will see that instantly you will get the alert on my iPhone here. Now I'll type 40. And you see it says 40. This is pretty cool, I think. And all the UI stuff is something I simply found on the internet and from something called React Native Elements. And if I want the rating, I just add it here and put in the rating code here. All this is ES2015 JavaScript, all in the browser and no building, no anything. You can actually also run the code in your browser if you want to simulate something. For this, I need to go to version number 19 here. So if I want to see how it looks on Android using React Native JavaScript, just click Android and I tap to play. And then there's some loading on the test environment. I guess that, you know, the number of people using this is high, therefore I'm running into a queue, it's called. See here, I have a simulated Android device. Now it's going to connect to my React Native app, and you will see the same result here. It's telling the load 40, and I can do some rating. I can change this, just a range. I've done some useless integration. That's what I want to see. You can see the link to this example app in my show notes. Happy coding.